toward the halfway point of the NFL season. Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Christian McCaffrey. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
First down.
Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
Yeah, with a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. This is McCaffrey. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. And on the stop defensively, Raekwon McMillan.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
The culprit dropping him for a 2-yard loss.
And it's third down. Third and 9.
Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. Rolling to his right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. Obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
I'm sitting here fucking sitting like I'm on defense. What the fuck am I doing?
After the turnover, it's Tua. Scrap for the football, and he's going to come down.
Get that shit, big man.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. So the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. Scrambling there, 12 yards, first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm, they had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. The gun, it's Tua. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Play 3 of the drive, not as successful. They go backwards after those 2 first down gains.
I'm over here watching the fucking Lions game and this is going on. WTF.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. Tagovailoa working out of the gun.
Oh, couldn't get it. They didn't get it now. Run that back.
Jimmy Smith blitzes for the sack. 2 straight sacks have him backed up now for a third and goal.
Oh.
Defense to help bring up fourth down.
This only had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointment.
Who's on the string?
Excellent field position. When that drive started, that's some points that they were thinking about.
In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here.
Tua Tagovailoa.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side.
Ah, fuck, man. God damn it, that's my tackle for fucking loss.
They have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
Some time right. He's going to let this go deep. Back over the middle.
Fuck, man.
Good effort there, trying to take a shot. But
does Cashman have tackle for loss option too?
But he reminds me so much of when my dad used to take me to the baseball stadium, watch the home run hitters and batting practice. I'll get to the stadium early just to watch this kid throw it. He can throw it out of the stadium.
Now a draw play to McCaffrey. Short gain there, so get it up
over. Gino, why?
Pick up there, it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
We often talk of situational football. Let's just call it team football. The defense did their job, got off the field, brought up a punting situation, so they're turning the ball back over to their offense. You think those guys are doing very well right now? Of course they will. Defense up the offense. Now it's their turn to take it downfield.
35 yards that time on the punt, and the Browns will take over first and 10. The Browns drive about to get started. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. Starts with a completion out to
that's
the
a loss too. Fuck.
Yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
It's Earl too.
Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards.
You gotta pull open, man.
That's what you're gonna need to do against those big receivers. You gotta get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Tua. Sideline. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
At the 28-yard line.
On first down, Tagovailoa. As he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, we always talk about you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket. But just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Tua to throw again. With the left side, it's complete. He's got it. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. They face a 3rd and 4 after that last completion gets them 6.
And 4.
Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa to the right side, and he's got Landry complete. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. First time these two have hooked up this afternoon, and it's a first down. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10.
Fuck, man.
This ghostface got me checking the rosters to see what the trade for the loss was. Missing the game and should fuck up.
Just, it's the appeal of it. If I can't trade for fucking Ross, I'll fucking make one.
Was like the end of the kids' school break. No more juice.
So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down. Mike Vrabel saw him on the sideline. He didn't even hesitate. They will go for it on fourth. They'll run for it with Pollard, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown.
Jeez.
Tony Pollard with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Browns add on to their lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football division, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Jack Ross, more like Jack Mellon.
For this next drive. It's been a rocky start for him thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully punts.
He's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just
fuck, that was my pick. I was all, fuck, man.
And they worked this well upfield across the...
Knew I shouldn't have been on that shit.
That is definitely what we call on defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson, when you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And some space here. And he is...
God damn it, man.
For a Baltimore touchdown.
Touchdown.
Christian McCaffrey. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens have cut it to within a score.
Sometimes running plays hit or break so fast, there's no reaction time from the second.
It's my fault. I got to feed backside, not fucking try to force catch me, man. Fuck.
Sorry, but one's won me.
No one downfield there to stop him.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Browns take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Cleveland offense ready to go, and they're hoping to redo. redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole...
Oh, what the fuck? I hate this fucking pump fake shit.
Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in 3-4 you don't normally get, because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. He'll rifle this one deep right side.
Oh, come on, big man, catch that.
Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side. And all of a sudden,
God damn it, man.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started.
Those wide receivers look so fire scrolling through the names, LOL.
it makes me feel better, just like, yeah. My knockoffs. I'm cool with them, bro.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Well, things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together.
It's my fault.
I'm eager to see how they decide to do it.
You better get to work on Blake Browski.
They want to take the big strike and go after it right now.
First play of the no wonder my fucking shit's all fucked up.
Blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Jackson being chased out left. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
A gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Oh, that was good.
Second down, and that's complete. This one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
27 on the play. First down, Raven.
Now a first and 10 at the 11.
The fuck is he over there doing? I gotta commit to fucking.
Touchdown. Lamar Jackson. His 19th touchdown now on the season.
I got Paul.
The Ravens have taken the lead. And that makes it 14-10.
Makes the score.
Ah, oh, fuck, can't right now. Hold on.
Browns 10.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this carries into the end zone.
Turn the net positive as he gets past the. He's at 49. No fucking clue why this is like that right now.
25 and up to the 27-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started.
And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes.
They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon.
Here's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark it down at the 39. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Consecutive catches for him. That good for 11.
First and 10 at the
from midfield. Here's Tua. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers. And somehow,
he's got 60 now.
They make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
This time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. Tua now on first down.
Oh.
And it's picked up by the Ravens. And nothing but daylight ahead. He's at the 30. Tim. Woo. And this is going to be brought back for an ultimate touchdown. And he has great speed, defensive back speed. Once he got and took off, there was no catching.
And I know every team tells you to hustle no matter what the play. There was no chance of catching him. Maybe if it had been a defensive tackle running with the ball, but not in this case.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game.
Oh God, he'll probably break out to run. Hopefully he fucking passes.
About 4 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee.
Well, the fucking sucked.
Yeah, shit happens, man. Dude, I didn't even know where the fuck I was in the pocket. I looked at X, saw him fucking start to pull down, and then next thing you know, I was fucking moved forward. I'm fucking watching Mark too fucking much, man.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. We're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play, because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so
if JB
deep,
was
really
a Madden play, that would be him.
Take the knee, get to the locker room.
There and quickly another first down.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. It'll be spotted on the right hash. A 52-yard attempt. And this one is right down the middle. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal. Not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Raven offense.
How can you joke so hard at times, but always kick so damn good, Joe?
And then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah.
Oh, if it comes down to a kick, we're all money.
As we'll head down to
Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Browns going to see the football first, but they trail here as we resume play on EA Sports. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
Two quarters to get Blake to superstar.
That's all I need.
To get started.
Fuck, man.
Close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
We'll see if they can pick it up. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that.
Does Mark even have it yet?
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense.
I'm not going
to
check right now. I can't waste my pause.
As much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Tua sets up to pass it. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be...
These fucking linemen ain't holding for shit.
I like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes to bring up 3rd and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a 3rd and 10. Going to the air. Tongue of my love.
Mark, come on!
I like what they tried to do there. Tried to hit him with something quick, get the ball in his hands.
Are you at 100 yet, so I ain't gonna fucking worry about your punk ass anymore?
Weren't able to do so on that play.
And here's Gillen on down to punt as he gets this one away.
Take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
How about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up.
Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here.
Scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 38. Throwing is Jackson. That's to McCaffrey complete.
McMillan, you're a bum.
Give him 6 on the play, and it'll make it a 2nd down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4.
I can't get fucking shit with Cashman. This motherfucker's literally like running away from him.
Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. Close to a 1st down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a 4th down.
Justin Tucker on for the field goal. A 49-yard attempt.
And this one looks good.
I know this is like a slow-motion train wreck now has even clocked in.
24-13. I don't even give a fuck about the win. I came into this ready to lose. I just need to get the fucking stat. Oh, my God. Like, I don't give a fuck. I don't need no touchdown. I don't need shit. I think I need like fucking 20 yards.
The Cleveland offense ready to go.
It's like he knows to avoid Cashman or something.
Yeah, and he's literally watching this one fucking wide receiver.
Here's Tua.
All right, Cashman, come on, man.
This is his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this.
Cashman, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Give him three on first down.
Fuck, man, get something. Damn it, man.
And that's where the return stops.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
That's a big piece of shit.
Matchup, which side has been the more physical one? It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Tua gonna throw. And he's gonna go down.
I got one receiver I'm fucking looking at. That's it.
It's a sack. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Some applause for the defense there. They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Jamie Gillen now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he'll just punch it out of there, and it's not a great kick. A returnable for Thomas. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and the Ravens, they'll take over.
Their own 43 yard
line. Come on, man.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. And that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Jackson looking to throw on third. Flush to his right. He may try and run for this.
I ain't even gonna fucking tackle with him. This fucking piece of shit.
Three and a first down.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
They'll run with McCaffrey.
This motherfucker's gonna run the ball. Like, he's coming in here like, yeah, watch me close this game out. Bro, I don't give a fuck. Take the fucking win. Go for the XP. Stop being a pussy. Nobody gives a fuck.
Inside run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do
I can't
worse
even fucking sub, man. Fuck
down.
Shit.
From the 25, here's second and six. McCaffrey.
Here, look, do you want the touchdown? What do you want? Score the fucking touchdown. Come on. So you know that you got it up, so you can fucking pass the ball. That's all I need. I don't need anything else from you but that. You're stop being a fucking bitch.
Almost like body blows in boxing. Slow them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
They'll try to run with McCaffrey.
Fucking shit.
He's down to the 2-yard line. A good pick up there, 7 yards, and it's going to be second and goal now.
Maybe 5-2.
That's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Start through 3 quarters, no reason to like
that. No, come on, count it. Fuck this, I got 28 seconds. Yeah, he's good. No.
Does it count?
No, it doesn't. He didn't have it. He didn't get it. Fuck!
Second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year, and the Ravens will add on to their lead. And the lead is up to 18 now.
Makes the score Ravens 31, Browns 13.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And a fair catch signal for and taken successfully.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on first down. Taken from just outside the 30. 40 yards on the punt, 2 on the return, and out will come the offense as they take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They've got a chance now to put this game away following that last defensive stop and punt. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
And for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Still have a lot of work to do.
But they don't want to focus on that now. Now it's about getting the ball in the end zone and hoping they can take it away again.
Yeah, still a three-score game, though, fourth quarter. The kick by Lutz is good.
Like a hair off today.
The deficit down to 15. Well, with that field goal, you can argue they needed to get back within two scores, and they did indeed do that, but still a pretty uphill battle.
Still got to take 2 fourth-quarter touchdowns to get back into it. As you and I know, that's a tall order against any NFL defense. They're going to need their own defense to make some plays as well to give them an opportunity.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
I would flip the pinch cover in the gap with the other LB so Cashman shoots in.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz. Pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here.
Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
On is the punter, Townsend, as he gets this one away. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. And what is going on here? Are they serious? 1st down, and they're in punt formation. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. A 40-yard punt, no return, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Next drive. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead.
And intercepted! Maybe the turning point they need! Picked up by Obi Melifonwu.
That's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on 1st down. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Just a 25-yard punt. Not what he was hoping for by any stretch.
At their own 34-yard line.
Set at the line for this next drive. And last time was a pretty one play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last
one.
And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a 1st down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground.
This motherfucker, man. I am so tired of motherfuckers being bitches. I am so tired of this shit. Oh, hey, yeah, look, oh, cool. I got you. Don't worry, I got you. I fucking got you. Do not worry. Fucking shit, man. Stop picking it off, Ward. Dude, I can't get shit. All I want is Cashman. That's it. That's it. All I want is him.
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. He'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes. And this one in the left-hand column. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2. At the 20.
Quick strikeout wide by Jackson.
Fucking shit, man. I'm ready to fucking miss this.
Hez not throwing two picks to Cashman blitz his ass.
Just over a minute to go in the game. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. Call a no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Well, they've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL. And he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time. So make sure you get in shape.
A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year.
Fucking shit.
Receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And what is going on here? Are they serious? First down, and they're in punt formation. Possession goes over here on the punt.
At their own 30-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And right about now, heck, they might be wishing they did not have a bye week coming up next week. The Bears are going to go into that week off in high spirits as they've got this one well in hand. A gain of 3, second down. Second and 7, operating from the 34. And they'll keep it on the ground. McCray. And he's got room. It's all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Big play there.
Fucking joke. I am so fucking blown right now.
I guess when you look back on it, it was
so fucking blown.
Until he popped a big one like that, and you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half, but there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally, here in the second half, that got done.
An incredibly short kick fielded way up. And a mistake.
At least you got 2-0 K for Evans.
All right, well, let me see what I got. Oh, man.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can't they? I mean, what a game. They put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball, and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it for a moment.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Baltimore, they move back over 500 now at 4-3. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again.
Come on, man.
Meanwhile, for the Browns, they dropped just their second game so far.
Worst feeling.
To 5-2. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week.
It's like 2-LS.
Against the Chicago Bears. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL.
Get the fuck out. Yo, I'm getting fucking hosed here. I'm getting straight hosed. This is bullshit. Fuck. Getting fucking hosed, man.
WTF only 5K.
Yo, I got straight fucking hosed. You've got to be fucking kidding me, yo. He's a 71 overall. He's fucking 22 years old. Nothing. Absolutely fucking nothing. Ew. Fuck this shit.